changes, interestingly, have been predicted by many ancient civilizations throughout the ages, talking about this moment in history as a moment in which we were going to encounter large changes on our planet, and that it was going to be a precursor to a change in mentality, a change in society, a change in technology that would be forced out of this large, somewhat cataclysmic change on our planet. We may find ourselves living in a completely different society. So what have I learned from my life's research? Oh my God, that's a lot. But if I could summarize it, and it might sound really esoteric and far-fetched, but I assure you, it's based on a lot of research. I believe that the history of our world may be quite different than what we've been told and taught. That in fact, the missing link between the Neanderthal and the Homo sapien is not just one link, but is a whole chain of events that have to do with advanced civilization coming to the Earth, finding the Earth in a very low level of evolution, and mixing their genes with ours to help the evolution along, producing the Homo sapien with a larger brain and so on. This change or this advancement in our evolutionary step is described in many, many different societies around the world, in ancient texts, in legends, in myths of creation, all defining these advanced civilizations coming to the earth, called the sun gods or the sons of God, having children with the women of the earth, or mixing their genes with the people of the earth to produce this new human. And I believe that that interaction with this advanced civilization has been there all along our history. That at first they may have given us even advanced technology, one of the most powerful piece of technology they had. A technology that could fly a ship, or produce large amount of energy, or produce fields that helps things grow, that can structure water, that can do all sorts of things that we would think of even today as miraculous. Within the next 15 years, we might start to see technologies that allow us to beat the gravitational field and levitate things, move off the surface of our planet, and really give the Earth back to the Earth, allowing the Earth to become the garden again, and us living in a completely different relationship. That very advanced technology, I believe, was present at the earliest time of our history, and then was removed eventually because of a need to allow our growth to mature before we would have that level of power again. I believe at that time a decision was made, however, to embed all the information we needed to recover that level of technology so that we could have it on time for the changes that are about to occur on our planet at this time. That information was embedded in religious belief and cultural structures, even in building practices, so that it would be encoded and passed on from generation to generation, to this time for you and me to recover and decode and applied properly. The advanced technology that comes out of this knowledge could have fundamental repercussion on our society, which would change our society dramatically from a society that lives really on a flat plane to a society that has access to what I call the Z-axis, have access to our solar system and maybe even access to our galaxy. I believe as well that there is a fundamental warning in all these texts, in all this knowledge, that says to us, when you get that level of technology, it is crucial that you have grown to becoming a benign, collaborative society instead of a competitive, warring one. And I think, and I see around me, and I see in the development of this planet and of this earth and our society at this time, that we are learning those lessons very rapidly. The field is very polarized. Many people are choosing peace, spiritual evolvement, and collaboration. And many are choosing war and competition. And it's becoming obvious which one is most powerful, which one is the one that is going to be necessary for our evolutionary step at this time in history. I am so excited to be here at this time in history when we're about to cross the event horizon of our evolutionary development into an era of galactic relationship, when we can rise to our full potential and become the galactic beings that we are.